Yeah.
It's funny.
Hey, no, not like that. Say it to you.
If anyone else wants to sign our
gosh.
Someone hold it on us.
What's going on, everybody? Bonjour. Danse. Zonge benesi in an age to kaskanuto dem. My name is Clayton Thomas Mueller, and I'm a Cree man from Pugadawagan First Nation, and I'm here to stand in solidarity with the Yinka Dene Alliance and the thousands of Canadians who are standing behind them to take on Enbridge today. Yeah. We're going to get this thing going here right away. I just wanted to get your attention and get everybody to start converging and also announce for our guests, members of the Yinka Dene Alliance, the travelers on the Freedom Train that arrived yesterday here in Toronto, in this territory of the Mississauga New Credit First Nation, who I would like to acknowledge. If you guys can start converging together, we're going to get started shortly. So please talk amongst yourselves, and we'll get started here in a couple of minutes. Aho.
Aho. Aho.
Okay, I'll turn the sign just for you, Jeffrey. I'll go like this. I'm trying to take a picture of hello. Thank you.
Enbridge End Day, eh? Yeah. I just want to call your attention right now. For those of you that have your own spiritual path, your own way to pray, and for those of you that perhaps don't pray, at this point, some of the women will be taking care of the mixing of these sacred waters from all the rivers and lakes and the ocean that were touched by the people traveling on the Freedom Train. And this water ceremony symbolizes the coming together of that sacred water that flows in each of our veins and that binds us as members of the Five-Fingered Nation. It is a commonality that we all share that unites us. And in a good way, I just want you all to speak to Creator in your own way and pray for that water, because that's what we're all here to fight to protect. And if you don't pray, then think of that higher power, whether that's the smile of your child, a beautiful spot in the sacredness of Mother Earth. Put that in your mind Well, we mix that water. But we're going to have a couple speakers after we're done this ceremony here. And then we're going to march to Enbridge. Yeah. So if you could, in a good way, just show humility and reverence for the sacredness of that water while we take care of this. And we'll get into the speakers in a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, this water here is from the Stuart River, Nakalkoat, and Nakesley in the central part of British Columbia. This water is from the Kukaching. I hope I said that right. Is it close? Okay.
Hey, Siam, Hotchka Siam Siaya. Chief Kalutstan Snot to Slayer to. Chief Yopunan Snot to Slayer to Squamish. This is the water, salt water from our coast.
From that big territory, BC. The Kainai people. Woo! This is what we're here for. The water from your lips is a pretty good taste. Let me say you. Saka say you. Sky say. We've mixed our water, we've mixed our heart, we've mixed our mind, positive, that tomorrow we will drink clean water, beside.
Well, that is the core of our being. Allies, everybody standing here today, is that sacred water. Each and every single one of us, when we come into this world, we spend that first 9 months of our life immersed in that sacred life-giving water in our mothers. And so, as a young man, I'd like to recognize especially these strong women that are leading the way for all of our people of the Five-Fingered Nation and that carry that sacred life of Mother Earth. We're going to have a couple of speakers here before we begin our march to the doorsteps of the Corporation of Enbridge's AGM shareholder meeting. And first, I would like to introduce Chief Thomas of the Saikas First Nation to share a couple words with all of you who have come today to stand in solidarity. Please join me in welcoming Chief Thomas.
Good afternoon, Toronto. And good afternoon, my brothers and sisters and relations that have been with us across this country. I want to thank all of you for the support you've shown my people. I come with humble greetings and thanks for having your ears opened and your heart opened to hear this message that we've been bringing across this country. I want to thank all those anonymous people that just gave me money on the street as we were talking and walking. Because of you, I have strength to keep going and more energy to keep going. When we're talking of this issue, we're not talking of any color, because water has no color. We all need it. We all depend on it. And as my brother said, it's the last thing we ever drink before we leave this world. I want to thank our host territory, the Mississauga of New Credit, on whose territory we are, and for allowing us to do this business in their land. On Sunday, it's Mother's Day. And as we think of our own mothers, and as we teach our children how to respect a mother, I want you to think of Mother Earth also and show her some respect. Masi.
Hereditary Chief Nahmax of the Wet'suwet'en Nation.
Denny's at you. Saka's at you. Sky's at you. I call you three names. Denny's at you. Chief, male. Saka's at you. Chief, female. Sky's at you. Those who are learning, those who will be chiefs, those who will be leaders. I need to explain that to you because that's what you are. You are teaching Canada and the world, and you are leading them in a voice that stands together. As my sister said, when we speak with one voice, people must listen. We have one heart. We have one water. We have one soul. I am a hereditary chief. I am not elected. My name is thousands of years old. One day this body will go, but the name will continue. The words will continue. Unfortunately, you have a prime minister that people elected that speak against us. Your voice is the one that will quieten that voice that speaks against us. Your voice is the one that's going to ensure that Canada is strong and respected. Your voice is the one that'll say to the world, we are Canadians. We listen to our First Nations peoples. We are guests on their territory, and we respect the territory, the land, the water that we hold in conjunction with First Nations people. Today, I am proud to march with you. Today, I am proud to listen to your voice. Today, I am proud to be Chief Namax on your behalf, Misai.
I want to remind everybody, for those of you with your smartphones, to please visit freedomtrain2012.com and sign that petition. We have over 10,000 signatures just since the train started. Let's hit 15 by the end of today. So please go to freedomtrain2012.com to do that.
Hashtag.
I have two brief speakers, presentations left before we begin our march to the doors of the Enbridge AGM. It is with great honor and humility that I'd like to introduce a leader from Nakazle. Chief Erickson, please join me in welcoming Chief Erickson to the mic.
Hare Yinkadane. In our language, Yinkadane is people of the earth. And that's one of the things, the message we wanted to bring when we come from the other side of the Rockies. We've been very very successful with our message in British Columbia, and we just wanted to bring it to the rest of Canada. The fellow First Nations, you know, were very important, and the alliances we formed there. But this ultimately is a national issue, and it's been brought by industry, and it's just really brought solidarity to our nations and hopefully to the rest of Canada. What's really unique is the mixing of the water that we began over in the West and brought it here. And it's not only symbolic, but it's also unifying, because what's going to happen is we'll be leaving some of this water that's been mixed from across Canada. We'll be leaving it in this territory, and we'll be trusting it to you. And taking it becomes your responsibility to protect our water and our responsibility to protect your water that we bring home. The strength that's been shown to us and offered us in the unity, when we stopped in Jasper and in Edmonton, they waited in the rain in Edmonton till after midnight to drum us in. In Winnipeg, we got drummed in like you wouldn't believe. In Toronto, the drums were here waiting when we got here. And I'll tell you, Enbridge is going to hear them drums today. And we're going to teach them the one word that we really want them to understand in the dictionary, and that's no. On behalf of the Inkatene Alliance and all of the other people that have joined us, you're all honorary radicals today, and you can send your message to Ottawa, and you can send it to Enbridge, and I just really want to thank you for your support. Merci.
Gifting ceremony from the Inkatene Alliance, and then our march, is the Vice President of the Haida Gwaii Nation, Vice President Churchill. Please, Lord, you're welcome.
Hadalasis, the Lung Auskiltlaken, the Manu di Gudne Lausla. Good people, thank you for hearing me. I am so happy today to see all of you out here. As everybody else has spoken before me, this is not simply an issue that we're facing, but your children and your grandchildren are facing these same issues. Look at your small children, look at your babies. Think of what kind of hardship they'll go have if your fish, if the land, if all of the stuff is poisoned and destroyed through bitumen. All of us depend on each other. Water knows no boundaries. At the top of the mountains, it comes down through the waterways, and the waterways feed the ocean, and the oceans feed the world. Our fish don't just stay in little pens inside of Haida Gwaii territories. The salmon travel the world that were born in the Fraser, and they come back. We must keep everything clean. We can do nothing else but stand against this as a united people and get on that petition. Not only sign it yourself, but send it out to everybody you know who has a baby, a grandchild, has someone to protect, because we need to do this together. We will not allow that pipeline, those oil tankers, and we pray each day for the people in the tar sands who are actually dying and getting sick from what's going on up there. So thank you so much for being with us.
Now I'd like to invite up some of the chiefs and leaders of the Inkatene Alliance so that they can conduct a gifting, which is part of our traditional protocols. And then after this, we're all going to march. So.
Howdy, Martin Louis from the Natliwaten Nation. Inkatene. I'm bringing this paddle, Daketne, people that travel by water from Natliwaten. The second impact on our traditional land was first the fish, and then they went after electricity and dammed off a major waterways in close to our community. And this came from the bottom of that dam of the lake they call Utsa Lake now. And that's what these are made from. Oh, Clayton. I'd like to present you with this paddle. It's for speaking on our behalf. And Elder Ted White. Ram, it's your turn. This is all the wise words that you gave. We depend on people like you to make sure that we get the word across to Harper that environmental laws are something that needs to be protected by everybody. And Grand Chief Billy Erasmus.
If my wife's watching, good morning. Dante, Rihanna. I'm getting a little emotional. But it's okay to be emotional. It's okay to have feelings for each other, for our land, for the water, for the animals, for the little insects that are coming out now, for these birds, for the sun, for the wind, all those servants that are out there. We're told that, for example, the servant, the wind, which some of the first people that came misunderstood. They thought we were, what's the word? Lost. Well, they thought we were lost. They thought we were praying to, they thought we were pagans. I don't have the right word in my mind. But the wind, for example, the wind is a servant. And every day we're supposed to give thanks, we're told in our way. At the beginning of time, I can't get into all that story, but we say equesno. That means in the beginning, we were given laws. And we were given laws from the same person. He traveled all over this island. He traveled all over the world. And one of the laws was to give thanks every day. To give thanks for what we have. So we have to pray every day. And one of the things we have to give thanks for is the wind. Because if the wind did not perform its duty, we would die. Simple as that. If the sun did not come out today, we take it for granted every day. We don't even look sometimes. We get up and we're busy and we're getting angry with one another and we're saying, what's that Harper going to do today? But the sun comes out every day. And the sun's been coming out for thousands and thousands of years. And we have to give thanks for that. The sun is a servant, one of the servants. And that's why we have tobacco. Thank you for this tobacco. Now I can give thanks because I didn't have any tobacco. And thank you for this paddle because now I can paddle home. And we have to start marching, so when we do, let's have fun. Don't be afraid. There's nothing to be afraid of. We're all human beings. We think a little bit different. But really, we're from the big family, the human family. And we're here for this cause together. Busy.
All right, folks. So we have marshals. Marshals, raise your hands. Marshals are going to be leading us. I too just really quickly want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart to Yinka Dene Alliance for this great honor, and I'll spend the rest of my life living up to this honor, so thank you. We're going to have the
justice! Fight for him! Fight for him! Fight for him! Yeah!